an international recognition, but a little bit of confusion in terms of his elevation to superstar. But in terms of this competition, perhaps an advantage, he's jumping before some of the big names. If he can nail this one first time, it would be very, very useful. Well, certainly tremendous speed. Now then, he's got a red flag. Oh, that was huge. Jonathan's been saying all this season, he knows he's in 18-meter form once again. But it's just a question of putting it all together. There's the world record marker. It's marginal. He's just got to adjust his run-up slightly. He's seen that on the Giant scoreboard as well. But that was big.
Yeah, not only that, Paul, that will give him the confidence. Even though it was a no jump, he'll be full of confidence. He's not...
The greatest jump of his life. It was a new Olympic record. And part of the reason Harrison came back was because the Olympic Games were being held in the United States. And when the crowd saw the distance, when Harrison saw the distance, the stadium erupted. He waited for quite some time. He's got lots of friends out there in the stadium. But just take a look at this. Superb balance. A long, long step. Not far short of the pit. And that angle is deceptive. It wasn't close to Jonathan Edwards' world record, but it was one of the longest jumps of all time. A tantalizing 17 meters 99. So the big question mark is now, can Jonathan Edwards respond to that? If he can repeat what he did in the first round and just stay behind the board, he could really nail it in this second round. Well, it's a good jump, that's for sure. I think he was running well within himself, but it's a red flag again. So Jonathan Edwards has really put himself under pressure here. 17 meters plus would probably do it. He has to be behind that small white board you can see down the runway to make sure he can then challenge for medals. What on earth is going through his mind now? He's certainly not hanging about in terms of speed on the runway, perhaps just holding back a little bit. Oh, the white flag is up. Now then, I think just about everybody in the stadium, all those people watching back in Great Britain and around the world who've admired this man for what he's done in athletics, their heart was fluttering just a little bit as well. But has he got the distance? We've seen it first. It's 17 meters 13. Dare I say it, I'm fairly convinced that's going to be enough.
Yes, he can now sit back, concentrate now, and get back into the competition proper. That was about survival, and it was a brilliant display of character. It really was. 17 meters and 13, no jumps. He had to get a good jump, it had to be valid, and he's ranked that. But
nerve-wracking moments before he took his third jump, but it was safe, it was a confidence booster. And if he can get into Gothenburg mode now, where he was jumping so well, his confidence, despite taking a dent by that first round foul, must be a little higher, because he knows he's in shape. Oh, tremendous sight! Oh! He's watching, we're watching, everybody's watching, and you've seen it. Have we got a competition on our hands now? Now, Kenny Harrison has looked very, very relaxed since he did it. 17-99 to beat. It's still just the fourth round, remember. Harrison yet to jump in this round, but we've seen Connolly produce his best. That is Jonathan Edwards, very nearly at his best. Oh, it's 17-88, we can tell you before it comes up on the screen. But Jonathan's got two jumps to go. Connolly has just had a big shot, and I think Kenny Harrison has too. The world champion is back in business. Without wind assistance, Kenny Harrison is one. This man is the other. There's a little sparkle in his eye. Well, it's long. It's a red flag again. Oh, my goodness. Jonathan Edwards. Come on, it's got to be long. It has to be long. But the rules are the rules, and it doesn't matter how long it is. Jonathan Edwards' gold rush here in Atlanta is over.